Is what we go through in life because of destiny or because of karma?
What is the difference?
If everything is destiny, then do we decide things and ways in our life, or we choose and decide because it was destined?
That question to answer, please tell me, who are you? When I say I or you, decide who, which part of you are deciding? If you are deciding so much, please decide to stop your heartbeat for half an hour. Few seconds also. Possible? No way. So, see, you cannot take many decisions, I'm telling you. A time, a space, a situation, an event, a particular team of people, this is provided. See, all of you have come from various locations here, right? You know, did you know that you will be here today at this time last year?
No.
Nobody, none of you knew that you will be here at this time last year, right? But today you are here. This is what I call the time, space, junction. That means at a particular time, at a particular space, a particular set of people assembled for a particular set of experiences. This is destiny. This is destiny. Destiny is defined by the time, space and activity. A particular thing will happen only at a particular time, at a particular place, to a particular set of people. You cannot change it. This is destiny. Now, in this, what can you change? Maybe you can sit on this seat or this seat. But experience, location and all the other things you cannot change. So, if we feel I chose to come here at this time, it's a mental illusion. It's an illusion. We always live in this illusion. Please understand. We always live in the relative truth. In the relative truth format, relative truth is something which is impermanent, not permanent. This is called Maya. What is Maya? Relative truth. Truth which can be defined up and down. Means a truth. This is truth. It is truth. But it is not stable truth. When I say stable truth, see, I can say, oh, this is sunset time. Or it is past sunset. Another person say, it is night. So, I said past sunset, which means night. I am right. But another person said, no, it's not past sunset, it's night. He is also right, I am also right. But if I say, it is 7 p.m. and he says it is 7 p.m. then it is absolute truth. We live in a state where I say it is past sunset. Am I right? And based on that thought, I have created my reality. Another person says it is night. And based on which he created his reality. Both of us are right. But both of us are not absolutely right. Our whole life is revolving around this partial truth. This is why so many problems are created on earth. Because of partial truth or relative truth or Maya. Absolute truth is when both person or few people say the same thing. This is it. You know? This is how life is working. Now, I told you time, space, junction. Destiny operates on precision. You cannot change it. I'm sure you know the story of Mahakali and the Navadutta, right? You know the story? A Navadutta was living in a cemetery, burial ground. This is a true story. He lives in the burial ground. In the night, Mahakali and all the ghosts and the cows and all these people come and dance in the funeral pyre. So this Avadhuta will sit and watch the show. Usually, they are so ferocious, people get frightened and they die. This man had no problem. He was an Avadhuta, he was a great master. He used to watch the show. One day, Mahakali saw this man watching. And you know, gods cannot dance in front of mere human beings. So she came to frighten him. All of them came to frighten him. Nothing was happening. He was looking and laughing. And then they thought, why this person is not affected? Then she said, you are the first human being I am seeing who is not affected or who is not afraid of me or any of us. Then he said, no, you danced very well. I really enjoyed it. So Kali was really thinking, what's wrong with this person? So Kali said, you are the first person. I'm very pleased with you. I want to give you some moon. I cannot go without giving you a blessing. Then he said, no, I'm entertained well. I don't need a blessing. I'm fine. So she said, no, you asked for something. Then he thought for a while. He said, I want to live for one more year. So Kali said, no, that's not possible. Before you took birth, you chose the time of death. I cannot change. Then he said, okay, then give me one year less. Basically, he never wanted anything. So he's just entertaining Mahakali. So he said, 1 year less. So mother said, no, I cannot even reduce it. You chose the time of death, that time you will die. Then he said, okay, make it 1 month more. Compromise. She said, no, I cannot do that. Okay, 1 month less. No, 1 hour, no. He said, you can't give me any blessing. I don't need it. Then she said, you ask me something which I can give you. So he had terrible problem with one leg. It was hurting leg, hurting. It was bad. Then he said, this leg has been suffering for too long. Right? This leg was enjoying. No pain. So you do one thing. You transfer this pain to this leg. So this leg can enjoy a little. You see? So Kali transferred the pain to this leg and left. See, that the point I'm saying is that even deities do not interfere in your chosen destiny. That means you chose a time of birth and a time of death. This will happen in precision. Then, how do you say that you are controlling life? What life are you controlling? This is an illusion. That I decide, I control. I do nothing. What life I control? So, how can we judge another person? How can we say this person is right, this person is wrong? Based on the destiny, people are acting their roles. People are acting their roles. Nobody can say, this man is right, this man is wrong. It's impossible to say. So, in this whole context, if you look at life, you will automatically surrender. That is why we wake up and say, Kayena Vacha, Manasendriya Iva, Buddhyatmanava, Prakritesopava, Karomi yatyat sakalam parasmai Sri Narayanayeti samarpayami. Whatever I do with the organs of action, organs of perception, today with the body, mind, intellect, ego, I surrender to you and we offer it to Lord when we start the day. And we end the day with the offering to Lord Shiva, the Lord of dissolution. He dissolves, he recycles things. Karacharana kridamva Kayajam karma jamba, Shravana nayana jamba, Manasam vaparatham, Vihidam avihidam va, Sarvameda chamaswa, Jaya jaya karunabhe, Shri Mahadeva Shambho. And we go to bed. That means whatever I did with my body, mind, intellect, organs of action, organs of perception, whether it was suitable or unsuitable, good or bad, with my knowledge or without my knowledge, consciously or unconsciously, I surrender to you, Lord Shiva. Let me sleep now. That means you do not take ownership. What Lord Krishna says, if you surrender your actions and the results of actions to me, I release you from the sins of it. You are free. That means doership creates karma. Understand? Your doership is creating karma. You feel I am doing, that is creating karma. If things are happening through me, what karma? No karma. That is why it says surrender to the existence and offer to existence. You are free. No more incarnation, it's liberation.